Hello friends, in this video I am going to discuss the equivalence of Clausius statement and Kelvin-Plank statement, as both these statements are different, but with the help of this particular description I will show you how this Clausius statement and Kelvin-Plank statements are equivalent. So as we know, the Clausius statement and Kelvin-Plank statement both are different. These are two different statements. So first let us see these two statements. So if we see the Kelvin-Plank statement, so it is representing, it is impossible for the heat engine to produce net work in a complete cycle if it exchange heat only with bodies at a single fixed temperature. And if we see the Clausius statement, so it is representing, it is impossible to construct a device which is operating in a cycle will produce no effect other than the transfer of heat from cooler to hotter body. So here both the statements are representing the two bodies. One is source or to reservoir and other is sink. And in between we have one device. Suppose the device is heat engine. So here with the help of source, which is at higher temperature, the heat is transferred to the device and that device will produce some work, and then remaining heat which is not converted into the work, it will transfer to the other source or other reservoir, that is sink, which is at lower temperature. So this is about the heat engine. But suppose if we are considering refrigerator or heat pump, so here we have to do some work and the heat will transfer vice versa. The heat will transfer from lower temperature to higher temperature. So here we have to do expansion work or compression work. So here the expansion work is work done by the system, and compression work we are considering work done on the system. So these are two statements of Kelvin-Plank and Clausius statements. So here if we see these two statements, so these statements are different, but these two statements will be proved equivalent by showing the violation of one statement implies the violation of second and vice versa. So here we can show the equivalence of Clausius statement and Kelvin-Plank statement with the help of one diagram. So in this diagram we are considering two devices. One is heat engine and another is heat pump. So here we have two reservoir. One is hot reservoir and another is cold reservoir. Suppose hot reservoir is maintained at temperature T1 and cold reservoir is maintained at temperature T2, and this T1 is greater than T2. So this is our condition. Now we talk about heat engine. So in heat engine we will get heat from high temperature or hot reservoir, that is Q1. It will transfer to the heat engine and it will produce some work. So the net work done we can define on the basis of, here we will consider the rejected heat Q2, which is not converting into the work. So net work done will be Q1 minus Q2, and the remaining heat Q2 will transfer to the cold reservoir which is maintained at temperature T2. So this is the working of heat engine. Now if we see heat pump, so in this condition the heat will transfer from cold reservoir to hot reservoir. So Q2 will transfer to heat pump, and here we have to do some work to transfer higher amount of heat to the hot reservoir. So here Q1 is greater than Q2, and in that case if we want to transfer the heat from lower temperature to higher temperature, we have to do some work over the system. So this is the concept of heat engine and heat pump. Now here let us consider this heat pump. So in heat pump, which transfer the heat from cold reservoir or lower temperature to the higher temperature or hot reservoir which is maintained at temperature T1 with no work. Here if we are not considering any work done on the system, so this is violating the Clausius statement. Suppose if we are considering pump work or the work done on the system is zero, In that case, there will not be any work done on the system. So this particular condition is violating the Clausius statement when we are conceding work done on the system is zero. So here this WP or W, which is on the system we are considering, that will be not considerable. Now this is about the violation of Clausius statement. Now let's see the heat engine. So suppose this heat engine is a cyclic heat engine which transfer the heat from hot reservoir to cold reservoir by producing some net work in one cycle. This particular process we are considering as one complete cycle, Q1, then net work done or the work done by the system, and then transfer of Q2 to the lower temperature. So this is representing one cycle. So here we are considering transfer of heat from hot reservoir to cold reservoir by producing some work in one cycle. Now here the amount of heat from hot reservoir, that is Q1, suppose if it is equal to heat discharge by the heat pump, here how much heat is discharged by the heat pump? As per this concept, the heat discharged by the heat pump is Q1 and it is transferred to the hot reservoir. Now, same heat Q1 is transferring to the heat engine. So, this Q1 and this Q1 is equivalent. So, here in this condition, the amount of heat drawn from the hot reservoir Q1, which is discharged to the heat engine or which is transferred to the heat engine, it is equals to heat discharged by the heat pump. So if we eliminating the hot reservoir, in that case, suppose if we are eliminating this particular heat reservoir or hot reservoir, in that case, what will happen? When we are eliminating this hot reservoir, so the heat extracted directly from the heat pump and it will transfer to the heat engine. So here, what we will do, we will cancel out this part and we will directly transfer this Q1 to the heat engine. So here, there is no role of heat reservoir or hot reservoir here. In that case, what will happen? So in this condition, heat pump and heat engine will work together. Here, we are removing hot reservoir. So this heat pump and heat engine will work together and it will produce net work, and that net work we will consider as Q1 minus Q2, and it's working, this particular system is working on single heat reservoir, that is T2. And this particular condition is what? This particular condition is violating the Kelvin-Planck statement. It is violating Kelvin-Planck statement. So when we are considering work done on the system is zero, it is violating the Clausius statement. And when we are considering Q1 from the heat pump and Q1 which is moving toward the heat pump is equivalent, so there will not be any role of heat reservoir or hot reservoir which is maintained at temperature T1. So we can directly extract the heat from heat pump and we can transfer the same amount of heat to the heat engine. So here heat pump and heat engine are working together. So we have only single reservoir that is maintained in T2. So it is, this particular condition is violating the Kelvin-Planck statement. So with the help of these two conditions, we can define the equivalence in Clausius statement and Kelvin-Planck statement. Thank you so much.